What's going on, champs? It is your boy P-Bet back with day three of Second Chance, which I was supposed to, you know, post yesterday when it was actually day three, but, you know, I kind of got caught up watching Rango Beast movie. But let's get on with the topic. Today's commentator, guys, it baffles me. It really baffles me how this guy only has like 100 something subscribers, because this guy deserves at least 20,000. This guy is absolutely hilarious. And this is like a pretty big thing to say, but I think he is up there with, you know, probably around my favorite, my top, you know, I guess my top 10 commentators of all time, which is saying a lot. So I really hope you guys enjoy today's commentator, which is Tasty Eli, and he's here with some Killzone 3 commentary, and I like that, because he didn't pick Minecraft, he didn't pick Black Ops, he's switching it up, and I like that. You have a better chance of getting on Second Chance if you switch it up, because nobody likes to see stuff that everybody does. So guys, enjoy Tasty Eli. Peace out.
What's going on, guys? My name's Eli, and I'm here to talk a little about myself, my channel, and I also got some Killzone 3 multiplayer coming up for you. I don't know how many of you seen that. Especially, hopefully, if all turns out well, you'll be watching this on P-Bat's channel, which would be more of a relief than the time you come home after a long day at school and drop a fat shit in the toilet and even splashes up nice, refreshing, cool water under your butt cheeks, and it just feels fantastic. So, today I was gonna render out another Black Ops video, just like every other Joe on YouTube. Don't get me wrong, I love some of the big Call of Duty commentators as much as the next guy, but I don't know about you guys, but Call of Duty gets old, so instead of bringing another Black Ops video, I decided to bring some Killzone 3 into the mix. P-Bet does have an extremely diverse channel, unlike my school. My school is around 85% black, and I'm a 16-year-old white guy, so I do not fit into the picture. I wear skinny jeans, and I just stick out like a boner in a room of vaginas, you know? It's just weird. So let's talk Killzone 3 multiplayer for a little bit. This far into the game, I was really surprised to see how well it is going at this point. At the beginning of the game, a lot of classes really pissed me off, and what I mean by a lot of classes was one class. There's a class called the Infiltrator, and the Infiltrator had a really solid gun with it. By default, was a shotgun, and 9 times out of 10, you're going to pick up a one-shot kill. It's a very powerful weapon, and along with that, it had an ability you can cloak yourself and appear as the enemy team, which is basically fucking bullshit, and you ended up getting stabbed right up the asshole really often. But as you play more and more of the game, you find out that this game is actually really, really balanced. And you could say one class is overpowered, but all the classes are equally fucking super powerful and just rape the shit out of everything in its own different way. Like, the Marksman class has a different type of cloaking ability where you can turn completely invisible and run around with a sniper. By the way, sniper in Killzone 3 is fucking badass. I don't know where it got the reputation of being shit that I've heard before. That could be just because of the lower frames per second it plays on as compared to Call of Duty. I think Call of Duty sits in around 60 frames per second, so it has that really smooth, like the inside of a butthole kind of deal. Really easy to just move around in. Well, that's not an asshole at all. If you do have an asshole, it's really easy to move around in. I'm sorry about your uncle being a big douche and treating you like that. But this game is a little bit rougher. You feel like a big fat ass kid in a pool of caramel. It's just so hard to move around. But you get used to the sensitivity really quickly, and it's just I was really surprised to see how easy this game was adapt to as compared to another game with that slow, I don't know if frame rate is the right word, but that like slow sensitivity kind of feel like a Battlefield, which is notorious for Call of Duty players coming over and just bashing to death because it's sensitivity is just fucking them up. So yeah, other than the sensitivity issues, having to adjust to that, I'm really, really enjoying Killzone 3. It's very balanced by bullshit. Like I said, that Infiltrator guy looks like your teammate. However, the class I'm running right here, I was running because the previous game, a lot of those guys were running that Infiltrator class, so I used the Tactician class. It has the ability to send out like a UAV type strobe off your person, and it shows up on a red dot on your screen, so those guys will be like, hey, look at me, I'm being a sneaky infiltrator, and I give them the old fist up asshole and say fuck you. And so yeah, and then and counter to that Tactician class would be the Marksman class, who's the ability to jam the UAVs around him and turn invisible and shit. So there's a counter to everything in this game. In its own way, each class is extremely fucking super good, as I said before. But yeah, this game overall is really clean cut, and I don't feel like it got the attention it deserved. It definitely had the possibility of being a powerhouse, and it really kind of sucks. I mean, it took some really solid steps from Killzone 2. And I don't know, I feel like it's a really solid game. If you guys haven't picked it up, I would definitely rent it and check it out. It's a really good alternative, and it has a lot of... It's very playable, and it's really easy to hop into. It's huge game modes. If you're shit at the game, doesn't mean you won't lose every game. So yeah, if you're open to new games, definitely give Killzone 3 a try. And if any of you guys do pick up Killzone 3 or already have it and you'd like to play with me, send me a message on YouTube or on a PSN, and I'd love to party up with you because this game's a lot more fun than a party. So with that said, I'd like to talk a little bit more about my channel and my YouTube stuff with the tiny little slim amount of time I have left. So yeah, a friend of mine pointed out this video to me and said maybe I should give this a try just to gain a little bit more of a following. He suggested to do so. It's because our channels are pretty related, and that's what I was worried about. It's because I didn't want to get on some, like, you know, it wouldn't make sense. Like, if I was to get on a church's YouTube and they're saying the Ten Commandments and I'm giving you 10 tips to get mad pussy, it really wouldn't work out that well. And that guy got fucked up right there, by the way. And guys, what I mean by our channels being similar, to sum it up really easily, is basically me and PBAT's audiences will be about the same. They like the really simple but really fun content. Hopefully you think I'm at least halfway as charismatic as this kid is. But anyway, guys, if you enjoy PBAT's channel, come over and check mine out. They're pretty similar. And if you like what you see, subscribe. And if you like this video, for sure come out, scope out my channel. If you like what you see, yet again, subscribe. Hopefully we can have some fun with this stuff, guys. Anyway, my name's Eli. Thanks so much for PBAT. Having me on his channel is a fucking awesome opportunity. Can't think of a much better way to give back to subs than that, brother. Anyway, guys, that finishes up the round. Final score of 14-2, and as you can see, I got two ass. That's how they abbreviate assist on Killzone. So, yet again, thanks, PBAT. We'll see you guys later, hopefully. Peace.